Hey, how's it going, guys? I'm Up All Night Gaming, playing Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn once again. I just got level 30 on my Rogue class, and I'm about to unlock Ninja, so I thought I'd do a little gameplay video of the quest, and some thoughts on Ninja, and how it plays differently than Rogue. So let's talk to Jack. Peasants by day, ninjas by night. Jack has just the job for a Denver Cove like yourself, and we'll get Soul the Ninja. And also, Tin, make the ritual Mudra hand gesture for heaven. Okay? Not really sure how ninja spells work yet in the game, so let's find out. Ah, show, keeping your stabbers sharpened, I hope, because I've got the job to be done, and I reckon the Dimber Damber, what put the executioners on the chopping block, is just the one to do the doing. My men have sighted some shifty types around Wineport of late, not code-breaking curs, so far as I know, and that's the rub, we don't have half as much about them as I'd like. They claim to be simple peasants, refugees from some far-flung realm, but I don't know many peasants what skulk about in the Darkmans as much as they've been doing. So long as they've not been breaking the code, they can do as they please, but being who we are, it falls to us to look into the matter and make sure it's all wop. As my gut tells me, this may be a two-rogue job. I've sent Underfoot on ahead, so pull on your best beater cases, head to Wineport, and meet him here. Meet him there. Alright, so we have to meet Underfoot, which is that Lalafell, at Wineport. So let's go ahead and teleport to Wineport, which is in Eastern Lenosia, I believe, by Costa del Sol, yeah. You know what I should have done? I should have teleported to Costa del Sol, because it's my free port, but I wasn't thinking. Ah, whatever. I'm just ready to become a ninja. It's taken forever because everybody is playing Rogue, and so the only means to level fast is to fate grind and leave quest. So I've been doing a lot of both, and it's taken, it seems, forever. Alright, let's talk to Underfoot. So, when Jack said he'd be sending one of the guild's canniest coves along after me, I had a feeling it might be you. Now I love to tell you old Underfoot's already whittled with the whole scrap on our friends, but truth is I've turned up more questions than answers. They claim to hail from the South Sea Isles, but me little birds at Melvin's Gate swear to the last man that that's some piss poor mummery. There's no record of any such ship sailing into port. Looks like it falls to you and me to take a closer look, Snilch, eh? I hope you brought your sharpest stabbers, as there's no telling who we're... Did you hear that, lad? Either old Underfoot's gone daft, or some mort just screamed out for dear life. I didn't hear anything. Something tells me our little task is about to take a turn for the interesting. What say we go see what's what? Alright, something's going down. Let me, put a food buff on really quick. Oh, wait, hold on. Oh, I have 5 behemoth. I don't know when the hell I got that. Okay, whatever. Let's see what's going on. Maybe it's up here on the roof. Oh, over here. Queer maid. Have mercy, I am but a simple milkmaid, with not a single guild to my name. Rest easy, lass. My friend and I don't mean you no harm, though I must say you've got me curious. Just what in the name of the 12 happened here? I had just come to town to purchase some supplies. No sooner had I walked through the gates than I was suddenly accosted by 3 burly drunkards who demanded that I hand over all my possessions. To my good fortune, it seems the men had partaken a bit too heavily. When they saw the meager contents of my coin purse, they began to squabble amongst themselves. A fist fight ensued, and before I knew it, the 3 men were lying on the ground as you see them now. Sounds like Nemea smiled upon you today, lass, though might I suggest you be a bit more careful on your next visit. All manner of scurvy sorts frequent these parts, and you'll find that not all of them are blundering lackwits like your friends here. Thank you for your concern, good sir, and I rest assured that I will take your words to heart. Good day to both of you. Well, show, how did the girl's wit strike you? Mummery, I say. Seem like an upright lass. I'm gonna say mummery. You too? I was thinking the very same. Squabbling amongst himself. Just look, there's barely a scratch on any of these lads. I'd wager there's more to Rome Doxy than she's letting on. Come on, let's go drag and see what she might be hiding. Okay. The hell is that? A bat? Are we dealing with vampires? Alright, speak to Underfoot. Where'd he go? He's just right outside of town. Oh, why the hell am I running? Using my mount. Over here to the left. The hell ago? What's going on here? Like three more people died. And a right mess we've got here. You reckon these coves got on the wrong side of our lass? One thing's for sure, there are no more peasants than you and I. One look at these stabbers tells me as much. I have failed. I beg of you, take this and return it to Master Arboro, to Lady Subame. It's too late. The poor sod's dead. As for this stone, your guess is as good as mine. A lucky charm of sorts, mayhap. Any road, we best start moving our dew-beaters before the lass gets away. Her footprints lead in the direction of Upper Lanosia. Alright, so that one chick was an evil person, I guess. She killed these three people, and she killed the other three. And we just let her go. Alright, so let's go ahead to Upper Lanosia. Let's zone this way. Oops. I forgot I'm only level 30. I'm used to like coming in these areas when I'm like level 50 and my black mage. I can't wait till they take like zoning out in this game. Everything's gonna be like really big and open like it was in 1.0. I think that's what they said at the London keynote panel. That they, once they get rid of the PS3 version later on, down the line, that they'll make the world more bigger. Hopefully, at least. It seems kind of small right now. Some areas do. Alright, I need to sneak past these guys. There's the queer maiden again. Three more are dead. She hides behind a tree, as if that could hide her from me. The hell's this? She didn't really think she could fool me with those silly rags, did she? Or did she? Perhaps she's not as clever as we believed. Ah, and a mysterious savior rushes to the damsel's defense. Such chivalry, such compassion. Such folly. Little does he know that the girl is more than capable of taking care of herself. She's a ninja. And right on cue, Oboro the Dim leaps onto the scene to save his dear little swallow in the most uprising surprise attack the realm has ever seen. Cease your ramblings, Karasu, before I rip that tongue from your bloody beak. Yow! Our hero is wounded, a stab through the heart. His childhood friends stand before him, blades drawn and hate in their eyes. Oh, the tragedy of it all. The audience sobs. And what's this? A couple of bit players who have forgotten to leave the stage. Did one of them tell their part in the play is long since over? Oh, the faceless rogue shows surprising skill. Perhaps he yet has a role to play. I will say this much, unlike a certain someone, at least you, intrigue me. But other matters demand our hero's attention, and so the first act must draw to a close. Come, my pet. Wait, Karasu! Even quick to retreat that one. The two gentlemen from Wineport? Did you follow me here? Beg pardon, miss. My friend and I are here on behalf of the dutiful sisters, and you, sister, have some questions to answer. I've lived on the underbelly of society long enough to recognize when a man's more than he seems. So what makes this easy for us? So make this easy for us, lass. Just who exactly are you, and what are you doing here? And here's hoping to both your sakes that it doesn't involve breaking no code. So you are the rogues of whom Lady Yaguri spoke. Forgive me. We were remiss in not seeking you out sooner. Very well. You shall know all there is to know. My name is Obro, and she is Superman. We hail from a village in Doma. Oh, that's the chick from Doma, but she was like a different kind of race. That's where she's from. We hail from the village in Doma, several thousand moms across the sea. We are... but perhaps you have no word for what we are. In our own tongue, what might call us shinobi? Doma? The Imperial Province? The same, though it did not have to be so. Our countrymen fought with honor against the might of Garlemagne. What we lacked in number, we made up for with martial prowess. It was a battle we could have won, had we not been betrayed by one of our own. Our every secret, our every move known to our foe, the tide of battle turned on the morrow. Thousands of our countrymen were slaughtered, and Doma joined its neighbors under the Imperial yoke. The traitorous Kerr joined the Imperial ranks as chief of their covert operations, or so they say. That is the man you just met, Karasu. Though I am loath to call him a man. To this day, he whispers in the ears of the Garlings, making a mockery of those who once called him friend and brother, but no longer. We have come to Yorzia at our village elder's behest to see that Karasu pays for his crimes with his life. Come to a mill, treacherous rook who blew the gab on his comrades? You sound like a right bene cove. Consider old Underfoot impressed. Forgive me, this land and this tongue are still new to us. Nonetheless, we were able to lure Karasu here, but more than a few of his comrades gave their lives in the effort. And now this, was their sacrifice for naught? You have my gratitude. When one of our kind falls, tradition dictates that we return their soul to the village, that it may rest with our ancestors. What? Our fallen brother's soul calls out to this man? Could it be a sign? Are we fated to fight as one? I would take you on offer. We will instruct you in our art, the art of ninjutsu. In return, you will share with us your knowledge of this land, that it might be serve us in our mission. But Obra, he is not Dolman. He is not of the village. Look around you, Superman. Our brothers and sisters are fallen or gravely wounded, and today's failure makes it all too clear. We cannot hope to stand against Karasu without knowing the lay of the land. Can't say I'm thrilled at the prospect of losing a dimper damper like yourself, but hells, in my younger days, I'd like be keen to try my femme at some of these techniques myself. And the more my waddles take in, the more these two strike me as Benar and Benar folks. If you're keen to lend them your daddles, I'll not be the one to stand in your way. If you would know more, come to the dock storehouse at Raincatcher Gully. We shall await you there. Raincatcher Gully. Who'd have figured, eh? Anyway, the choice is yours, Shaw. In the meantime, I'm going to head back to Limsa and report to Jack before he comes and gives me a good clout in the knob. Alright, let's go become a ninja. Raincatcher Gully, where is that at? Let's see where it's at. Eastern Lenosha. I'm gonna go to Costa del Sol. Hopefully that guy doesn't turn around and notice me. Alright, good. Oh man, can't wait to be a ninja. Ninja was my favorite class in Final Fantasy XI, and I always played as Shadow back in the day on Final Fantasy VI. Like, I just can't wait to play as Ninja. I don't think you guys know. I mean, the hype is huge for Ninja, but for me, it extends like 10 times. It's crazy. But Ninja and Samurai are my favorite classes in Final Fantasy. Rain Catcher Goalie. So let's take the ferry a little bit north of here. The pumpkin on the ground? What the hell is this? Okay. That's really weird. Alright, let's take the ferry. Talk to the ferry skipper. Yeah. So I'm really stoked about 2.4. The only thing I've done though so far has been unlocking Rogue and leveling up. I want to get it to 50 as soon as possible. Get Ninja to 50 as soon as possible so I can do the other content and upload that as well, like the Hildebrand quest and the post-Moogle quest and the new storyline and Shiva and everything. Alright, let's talk to Oboro. And so we meet again. Might it take your presence to mean that you have chosen to accept our offer? Yes. Thank you. I speak not only for myself and Tsubame, but for our entire village when I say that you have our profound gratitude. What I would tell you next, I would tell you out of the earshot of strangers. By Yakubu, I think that's how you pronounce it, has been instructed to let our only trusted visitors through the doors behind me. When he speaks to you, Ayame, you are to answer, Kaede. You need not know what the words mean, only that they will grant you entrance. Ayame and Kaede, in the ninja quest in Final Fantasy XI, it was like a story about a mother that was like a secret ninja and she died or something. Ayame. Kairu. Kaede. Enter. I wonder if we'll figure out what it means as the story progresses. Wow, this place. The music. I love this. God, I love this place. Alright, let's talk to Oboro. Welcome, Sho. You stand within the provisional base of operations my people have established in your land of yours. It may not look like much, either without or within, but that is precisely the point. We find it an ideal vantage point from which to observe the comings and goings of Karasu and his men without attracting undue attention to ourselves. My fallen brother saw you as a worthy inheritor to his soul. To honor his memory, I entrust it to you. But soul alone will not make you a shinobi. No, this will require training of the body and mind. Our art, the art of ninjutsu, originated with our ancestors many years ago. Since then, it has been passed down with each generation, mother to daughter, father to son. We draw power from the world around us, the heaven, the earth, and the hearts of man, and channel this power into physical form. I am told that this is similar to your concept of aether, was it? I must confess that your Zian words and ways remain unfamiliar to me. How does one channel this power, you ask? Through the use of mudra, hand gestures that call forth each of the three forms of energy of which I spoke. The first mudra I will teach you will call power from the heavens. In Doma, we call this Ten. You are eager to learn, yes? Attune your soul to that of my fallen brother, then approach me once more. It is then that your training will begin. Alright. Ninja unlocked. Hell effing yeah. We are ninja now. No longer a rogue. Sweet. So let's equip the ninja soul. Oh my god, it feels so gratifying. Okay. Did we get any new weapons? No. Oh my god, this is so awesome. Nin. I haven't seen N-I-N since like Final Fantasy XI. Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay, let's put 10. Oh, we got other stuff too. Ninjutsu. Execute a specific ninjutsu action. Wait, okay. Execute a specific ninjutsu action coinciding with the combination of mudras made immediately beforehand. If any other ability and spell... I don't know. I'm just gonna hotbar these. Wait, oops. Delivers a ranged ninjutsu attack. Okay, yeah. How do I... It won't let me hotbar it. Why? Oh, okay, so I have to do a combination of 10. Oh my god. Oh my god. Alright, so let me put these here real quick. No, I need to... Trying to think. Sorry, I'm trying to like think where I want to put it. Ninjutsu, excuse me. Okay. I'm going to put this. Crap. I'll just put this. Right. This side. Yeah, I'll do this side. Okay, let me try this out. Okay, I'm just gonna talk to him, then we'll go outside and we'll try it. Just trying to understand the ninjutsu. My first mudra, Oboro, would give you your first lesson in the art of ninjutsu. Yes, I can sense it. Though you are not of our blood, the soul of my people is strong in you. You are one of us now, a shinobi. And yet your training has only just begun. Heed my words well, Sho, for the shinobi, blade and mind, are one. The weak mind gives rise to weak blade. The false mind gives rise to false blade. But the mind that is strong and true, that blade will know no equal. Such were the teachings of my master, and his master's master before him. The shinobi must keep presence of mind at all times, or his blade may as well be one of grass. This is the lesson of the mind. Now we shall begin the lesson of the body. You will recall that the art of ninjutsu involves using hand gestures called mudra to summon the energies of heaven, earth, and man. Tin, chi, and jin in the Domen tongue. Myriad techniques can be unleashed depending on the mudra you combine and the order in which you do so, but perhaps I am getting ahead of myself. A child must learn to walk before he can run. To begin, I would see your master, your first mudra. Tin, the mudra of heaven. Summon the energy of heaven and project it forth. And from your hand will fly a flaming star, or Fuma Shuriken. Outside of the storehouse, you will find a Mokujin, a wooden man of the sort traditionally used in Doma for training. Do as I have told you and strike it with a Fuma Shuriken. I will observe your technique from a distance. Okay, let's go outside. Sorry, I like needed to sneeze really bad for the past 5 minutes and it finally came out. Go outside and use 10 and then use Fuma Shuriken on the wooden man. Oh wow. It's really pink out here. The arts of ninjutsu. I guess those are other ninjas over there. Here we go. Let's use 10. And then Fuma Shuriken. Wow. That was badass. I want to go use that on a monster. Yes, that will do, Sho. Clearly we do not misjudge your potential. Perhaps you also felt your body becoming lighter. This is but another benefit of your training. You be mindful the true shinobi sees that movement is wasted. Okay, so we're going to do another challenge. You demonstrated your skills well against the woodsman, but wood does not strike back. Okay, so we're fighting another challenger. Alright, looks like we have to do an instance battle now. Okay. Here we fighting. The Anobi will attack in waves. Use your Fuma Shuriken to dispatch them. I'm ready. Oh my god, that's so cool. I use my throwing dagger while my thing is on cooldown. This is so awesome. Oh, look how I run. I run different. Oh my god. Sorry, I'm like nerding out here. So excited. What can we do? All of my key bindings are like messed up when I change to ninja. Crap, I'm gonna die! No! Your first final challenge, I shall be your opponent. Oh no, no! I'm not ready yet! Do I have any high potions? Dude, calm the fuck down for a minute. This is really hard. Go away! Shit, those things are gonna explode. Oh my god. That was close. All of my moves are mixed up. I have to reorganize them. But at least we won. Alright. I see. Lady Yugiri spoke true. What Oboro means to say is that he's not seen anyone master the fundamentals of ninjutsu with such swiftness. Is that not so, Oboro? I am capable of speaking for myself, Tsubame. Damn. But it is true. Sho has exceeded even my own expectations. His blade slices through the air as a fish glides through water. But that is enough training for the day. Now it is my turn to be the student, and you the teacher. I would learn the ways of Yorzia. Will you instruct me? Or you will instruct me, yes. You have my gratitude, Sho. Oh my god, it's so awesome. I just want that armor. First, I would better know the terrain of Lotnos. Is something amusing? Oh, you don't bow like that, you bow like this. My bow? I see. Who would have thought a simple gesture of courtesy would be so complicated? Like this, is it? Irk. Forgive him. Oboro has not been quite himself since coming to these shores. It would seem that neither the food nor the climate agrees with him. And let us not forget the stink of those infernal horse birds. All the more reason for us to complete our mission swiftly and return to the more hospitable environs. That should suffice for the day. Practice well your ninjutsu and return when you are ready for your next lesson. Oh man, so awesome. He did it wrong again. It would seem you have some practicing to do as well. Alright! We're ninjas. It's my birthday. Not really, but yeah. So the next thing we get is Chi. Make the ritual mudra hunjester for Earth. This is so cool. Oh wait. Oh, if I do it twice. I did 10 twice and it turned out to be a different move. Alright, I'm gonna go try this out on a monster. I think all these monsters are like level 30-ish. 36, yeah. Too high. Let's go to the other area. Man, I need to reorganize my move set. I'm gonna go to the other side really quick. Actually, I'm just gonna teleport to Coastal of Soul. Well, I guess I can't because it's not in here. Whatever. I'm gonna go try it out on these monsters that I need to kill for my hunting log. Let's kill one of these colibris. Alright, let's try it out. First, I'm going to use 10. If I do it again, it does something different. What the hell? Alright, so I did 10 twice. And this thing spawned on my head, maybe because I did, like, the wrong combination? I don't know if you guys saw that, it was kind of weird. Alright, I'm going to use it once this time, then use my Fuma Shuriken. Alright, now check this out. If I do 10 twice, maybe one more time, this thing spawns in my head. That's funny. Cool. I really love the way I run now. Check this out. Oh, I can't really see anything. There we go. Look, hey, this is how ninjas run. Check it out how rogues run. I'll take the ninja soul off. This is how rogues run. So you can see the difference. Oh my god, I'm so stoked. Oh my god, you see that? Look how I jump. I wonder if we'll get like double jump or something. So cool. Awesome. Oh man. I'm in love with this. Me use my mount really quick. Go over here. Look at that coastline. Alright, cool. Alright, well, thanks for watching my video, guys. Stay tuned. I'm gonna do the different ninja quests as I level up, so I'll share it with you guys. I love this class, I love this game. Can't wait to see more progression all the way to 3.0, Heavensward, and so on and so forth. I'm Up All Night Gaming, and until next time, I'll see you guys later. Bye.